Good morning. I've been meaning to make a new fan shroud since I first got my printer, and it's been almost 6 or 7 months now, and finally I've gotten around to designing my own. The shroud prints in three parts: the main body, then there's a small guard piece, and then there's the tip. The only point that needs support is right here. So if we set support at an angle of about 87, then it'll print only in that one area. And we just remove this support, and that'll just help with cable management. Also over here, there's a place to put some cable tie. Installing the fan is pretty easy. We just pop it in the front, and it holds itself in place. I made the shroud because I enjoy designing, and also my heatsink fan was starting to get a little bit loud. So the original shroud has a pretty heavy grill, and this is causing a lot of noise itself. So being quieter is nice, but the real benefit is that not only is it quieter, but it actually cools the heatsink better than the original. I ran temperature tests with a Bowden tube removed and a thermistor almost at the bottom of the throat. The test was at 200 degrees and lasted about 20 minutes. We can see there's a temperature difference of about 10 degrees. I ran the test more than once, moving the thermistor just a little bit, and got a similar result of about 10 degrees difference. I think that all those heat tests might have caused a partial block in my nozzle. If I take a look here, I can see I had some extrusion problems over here. I took a look in Cura and I found that the under extrusion was all happening along the Z seams. I had been doing some bridging tests, so I think I made a mess of my profile. Weight wise, it's also lighter. The tip comes in at just 1 gram. The shield is also 1 gram, and altogether we have just 9 grams. The original shroud comes in at 22 grams. If we consider also the original fan, we have 36 grams, which makes the new design a total of 19 grams lighter. Part cooling wise, it's still running the original fan, so we're not going to see too big of an improvement there, but I have made some adjustments to try to optimize the airflow, and we can check that out. So this shield here is going to prevent the hot air from going in and being used by the fan. Here we have a small clearance, but I've been printing for some time and I found that there's no problem being so close to the heat brick, as long as we have the silicone sock on. And these wires here can be tied down with the cable tie and can be ran in under together with the other fan wires. I'm planning to make a second version with double fans, and when I make the second version, I'm going to try to make it without screws. So these wires here can go inside the space that we made, and this whole thing here can also go inside, but we need to work it a little bit, and we can probably somehow clean this up. The fan is going to go in like this, and we need to run the wires around the side. This one also just slides in. Okay, so if we push the fan up a little bit, then we can take the guard piece and slide it onto the bottom of the fan. And the guard piece should line up right here. Then we can push the fan down again. Then we take the tip, and the tip has a stopper inside, so it should go in until the fan hits the stopper. And it should line up with the shield guard here. Okay, this is a 12 volt fan, so I've connected a buck converter. Let's heat the nozzle to 200 and see how much space we have to play with the voltage and adjust the sound. Sensor has been running for a while and the temperature is stable. We've got 12 volts. Let's get a sound sample and start. Okay, we've got a stable temperature at 9.5 volts. Still cooler than the stock fan and a little bit quieter. 11 volts sounded the best for me. So there's a lot of cleaning up to do. The buck converter should go together with the main board. And this mess of cables needs to get tidied up. This thing looks like a mess. And I still haven't tidied my BL touch wires. So, leave a comment if you have something to say. If you enjoy the videos, please like and subscribe. Thank you for watching and see you again next time.